Freeing the moment of seeing, meaning the very moment of seeing your own nature in the first and second instant or second afterwards, there is no thought. Thoughts have vanished. And honestly, is there anything more fantastic than being totally free of thought? But even if those just that short, because there's nothing else in this world that can totally bring a halt to thinking. You can blow up nuclear bombs and so forth and use all different techniques, but nothing really stops thoughts. But the very moment that you turn your attention towards your own mind, it is evident that it is simply an empty cognizance with no thing whatsoever. It's empty, and yet there is a seeing of that because mind is also cognizant, and these are a primordial original unity being empty and cognizant. But the thought happens that you don't believe that this is really it because it's too easy. There's nothing more easy than this, just like that. Okay. Don't think of anything, having totally abandoned thinker and what is thought of. In that moment, you've already seen that there's something to see. It's not something you gradually approach like a spirit entering. This is what is mentioned by the word, the phrase, in one moment makes a difference. In one moment, complete enlightenment. That moment, like this, is the unmistaken Buddha mind. Don't project outwardly. Don't concentrate inwardly. Don't keep a state in between. Totally give up any mental effort, utterly or sheer emptiness. You don't need to throw up your five senses, not at all. Like this, but just remaining like this, everything is vividly experienced. But if you start to investigate the label, you are involved in thoughts. This is what the Prabhupada says in the Sevenfold Supplication. No matter what appears to you in the realm or in the field of your vision before your eyes, the world, the beings, and so forth, even though experienced, just let it be without any fixation. In other words, disown everything. The dissolving of the subject and object is the pure form of the deity. Whatever moves or occurs in the realm of your ears or any sound, all resounding, whether pleasant or unpleasant, just let be in the continuity of sound being emptiness. Because no matter what resounds in your hearing is indivisible from emptiness. Empty resounding beyond arising and ceasing is the voice of the victorious ones. By leaving your thinking to itself, it dissolves naturally into Dhammapada. The thinking means our thoughts of this and that. If you just let it be, it naturally dissolves. So do you just wait for this? You don't do anything to it, accept or reject, hope or fear, then it's enough. That is sufficient. So what you naturally need to train in is to not imagine something by an act of meditating, but also not to be distracted for even a second. Being distracted is the same as forgetting. And it is said on the path of distraction, the demons lie in ambush. The moment you look towards and acknowledge empty cognizance, that is called having recognized. And then there is a continuity of empty cognizance, which you don't need to fabricate in any way. Just don't forget it. Once you forget and start to think, then the continuity is lost. The empty cognizance is seen, recognized. And then allow the continuity of this seeing to continue or be sustained, but automatically. Then for an ordinary person, again, a thought occurs. Then you remember, oh, I forgot. Then again, acknowledge or notice who forgot, and simply recognize again. And again, you arrive back in the state of recognizing your natural face. That doesn't mean sitting and straining, trying not to be distracted. It's like ringing the bell once and the sound continues. It doesn't mean ringing the bell continuously. Once the continuity fades, that means we start beginning. And we get involved in the thought. Then again, you notice, oh, I got carried away. And then, all right, then look towards. And again, you're back in recognizing. And again, there's natural stability in a continuous state of empty cognizance. We need to train that short moments many times. We have to train while involved in the activities of this life. For example, while eating, we taste the food, and we start to think about the food, and then notice, oh, I got carried away. Again, recognize while eating. In that moment, you arrive back vividly in the state of the essence. And you forget again.
Okay.
You get lost. Then you will, while walking about, moving in your room, so you can still recognize the Buddha nature. When you lie down to sleep, if you're diligent, also recognize again. When you say it, recognize. Actually, there's no time when you're not allowed to recognize nature of mind. Even when you sit on the loo. It is said like this, in the naked state of the Dharma Dato, which is unimaginable, relax the impeccable state of awareness. If a thought occurs, it arises from yourself and dissolves back into yourself. Any thought that occurs is your own expression, comes out of your own essence. It is only when forgetting the essence that the expression takes the form of a thought. But the moment you recognize your own expression, which arises out of yourself, dissolves back into yourself, meaning into the experience of the essence. This is what we need to train in to become used to. There's no other meditation, object or act apart from that. As much as that's not even. But if you forget, get distracted, we are involved in thoughts. So please train this. That is the practice. This is what Sri Buddha taught in the past. And today, he has nothing to say besides this.